Hi everyone, welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another integration by parts problem today. This one is the integral of x times e to the x dx. And the reason that we know that this is an integration by parts problem is because we have two components here in the integral that comprise the entire integral. It's not a partial fractions problem because we don't have a fraction here. It could be used substitution, but you're always looking for something to cancel when you use substitution, and you're always looking for the derivative of u to be something that will cancel out something that's already in your integral. So for example, if we assign u to e to the x, the derivative is e to the x, that's not going to cancel out the x here. And if we assign u to x, the derivative of x is just 1, and that's certainly not going to cancel anything out. So let's try integration by parts. Remember, the integration by parts equation is the integral of u times dv equals uv minus the integral of v du. So this is the equation we're working with, and we need to assign u and dv to identities in our integral here. So the easiest way to do it is to assign u to something that will become simpler when you take its derivative. So in this case, that's definitely x. The derivative of e to the x is still e to the x, which doesn't simplify at all, but the derivative of x is 1, which is much simpler than x. So we're going to assign u to x, and then we need to assign dv there by default to the other value in our problem, e to the x. And then from u and dv, we need to find du and v. We'll find du by taking the derivative of u, and the derivative of x is just 1. V we determine by taking the integral of e to the x. The integral of e to the x is still e to the x. So now that we've found these four identities, we can go ahead and plug them into the second part, or the right side, of this equation here. So you can see we have u times v. So here, u times v. So x times e to the x minus the integral of v, which we have as e to the x, times du, so times 1. And then we put in the dx here, its notation. This 1's going to go away, right? Because it's redundant. So we're just left with the integral of e to the x, which is e to the x. So x times e to the x minus, we take the integral, and we just get e to the x. And then we add c to account for the constant. And this is actually our final answer. If you would like to, you can factor out an e to the x. So you either have x e to the x minus e to the x plus c, or if you want to factor out an e to the x, you can do so. I'm not sure which way is simpler. You'd have x minus 1 plus c. Either way, they're equally correct, but that's your final answer. Hope that helped. See you guys next time. Bye!